the signet ring stage passes to another stage, amoeboid stage. This is another stage, that is amoeboid stage, and produce schizont, and then merozoids. This is merozoids. Then merozoids enter fresh RBCs and produce gametocytes. The gametocytes reach into mosquito stomach, when the latter sucks the blood of infected human host. So when the mosquito sucks the blood of infected human host, then gametocytes, it reach into the mosquito's stomach. The gametocyte produce male and female gametes in the stomach of the mosquito. The male and female gametes fuse to form zygote. The latter becomes worm like called okinete, which penetrates in the wall of stomach and form oocytes. This you can see, oocytes. The oocytes produce sporozoids, which are released in the hemocoel of the mosquito and reach into the salivary gland and make the mosquito infective. So in this way, the mosquito becomes an infective mosquito. So students, this is the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. Now we will learn the symptoms. The symptoms of malaria fever appears about 14 days after the infectious bite. Early symptoms include restlessness, less appetite, slight sleeplessness, followed by muscular pain, headache, and feeling of chilliness. In response to chills, the body temperature starts rising and may reach 106 Fahrenheit at the height of fever. The patient sweats a lot and the temperature steadily goes down to normal till the next attack takes place after 48 hours. So in this way, the once the temperature rises very high, then it becomes normal, and next attack it becomes again very high. So this is the symptom of this type of disease.